Hi, this is COMP1010 at the University of Manitoba. I'm Dr. Celine Latulip, and today I'm going to introduce you to the Boolean data type, true-false, and how to use that in simple if statements. Okay. So, you've probably seen flowcharts before, and this flowchart is kind of a funny joke flowchart about giving tech support to your family. So, we start here, and then we have a diamond, which is a decision box. So someone's asking you for help, find a menu item or button which looks relevant to what you want to do, and then you make a choice. You say, okay, and you click it, or the other choice is, I can't find one, and so then you have to do something else. So that's a choice, and this flowchart goes on, and you can read it, and it's kind of silly. So maybe you click a button, did it work? No. Have you been trying this for over an hour? No. Okay, then you go back and you find another button, click it. Did it work? No. Have you been trying this for over an hour? No. Go back and find another button. So here you can see this cycle until at some point it's actually been more than half an hour and you say yes and they say ask someone else for help or give up. Okay, so this illustrates two important points in computer science. One is the idea of choice, making decisions. And that's what we're going to be focusing on today. It also illustrates the idea of loops, repeating things over and over again. And we'll get to that a little later in a few weeks. Okay, so the three fundamental structures in programming are sequences. So do this, do that, do that. And we've been doing a lot of that already. And then choice. So you do A or you do B, depending on something else, such as C. Okay. And then repetition or looping. So do this again and again until some specific thing happens. Okay, so we've already done lots of sequences. Today we're going to look at choice. So choice are those diamond-shaped boxes and flowcharts, and it's typically controlled by a yes, no, or a true-false decision. And in order to make those decisions, we actually need this Boolean data type. So this is a really important data type. It controls everything that happens in a program. So a Boolean data type is a data type that can only take two values, true or false. And you declare it just the way you declare int variables or float variables. You have the type, which is Boolean, and then whatever variable name. So this creates a box in memory to store a Boolean variable called myBooleanVar, but it doesn't actually put anything in it. And of course, you could also declare and initialize at the same time. So in this case, we have Boolean, myBooleanVar equals false. So this creates the box in memory and puts false into the box. We could also put true into the box, but those are the only two things that could be stored in a Boolean variable. So if you look over here, what this looks like in processing, notice the syntax highlighting. So of course, our data type is in orange. And the value false here is in green. And if it was true, it would also be in green. And that's because true and false are key words in Java and in processing. You never want to call a variable true or false. These are reserved keywords that you should avoid using, except when assigning values to Boolean variables. Okay. When you have Boolean variables, they're not like numeric variables. You can't do things like plus, minus, multiply, divide, remainder. There are operations that are specific to Booleans, which we'll get to in the next video. But for now, what we want to do is, once we have Boolean variables, now we can start using basic if statements. So this is what a basic if statement looks like. We have the keyword if, and then we have round brackets, and inside the round brackets, we have an expression. And the expression could be a Boolean variable, or it could be some expression that results in a Boolean variable. So we'll look at some examples a little later, but what happens with an if statement is, if this expression is true, then the next thing we have is an open curly brace, and down here there's a closed curly brace. If this expression is true, then we're going to do the code that's in this block. And if this expression is false, then we're going to skip over this code and come down here and do whatever programming statements come after that closing curly brace. So over here is an example, and this is processing code. We set up a canvas size inside of our draw function. We say if mouse pressed. And mouse pressed is a built-in Boolean variable that processing gives us. And so if a mouse button is pressed, this is going to be true. If there's no mouse button pressed, then this is going to be false. So if the mouse is pressed, then we're going to draw an ellipse at the location of wherever the mouse is currently that's sized 50 by 50, okay? And so here in this canvas, you can see nothing was drawn, and then at some point, the mouse was pressed and dragged, and we drew a bunch of circles, and then the mouse button was released, and we stopped drawing. So we can actually look at what this looks like in processing. So here we have the same thing, except I've got a constant for diam, and I've set the background to black, but we'll play this. And you can see as I'm moving my cursor around in here, nothing is happening until I press my mouse button. And now I have all these circles being drawn. When I let go, now no more circles are being drawn. And when I start again, circles are being drawn. Okay, so this is processing, making a decision based on the state of something, whether or not it's true that my mouse button is pressed. Okay, so that's a simple basic if statement. We're just deciding to do something and or not do something and just continue down. So we have, you might be wondering, where do we get Boolean variables? I mean, we can create Boolean variables, but there are some built-in Boolean variables. So the one we just saw was mouse pressed. There's also key pressed. So key pressed will be true if you are holding down any button on the keyboard. Once you let go of that button, key pressed won't be true any longer. It will be false. And so we can use that. And you can check these out. You can play with these by in processing in your draw function, putting in these statements, print lawn mouse button, mouse pressed is, and you print out the value of mouse pressed. So this just sort of concatenates to the string true or false, depending on what this is. And you can have that in your draw function and you can press and let go of the mouse and press and let go of the key. And you'll see that these values will change. So if we wanted to draw a circle only when the mouse button is pressed, which is what we just did, then we do something like this. And that's what I just showed you. So that's a basic if statement and using Boolean variables. But there's actually a really common, slightly more complicated statement, which is the if-else statement. And this is really where we're giving a choice between two things. So in this version, we have if expression. If this expression is true, we do this stuff. Else, otherwise, if this expression isn't true, if it's false, then we do this stuff. So, and then after we've done either this or we do this, then we continue down here. Okay, so this would be called the if block and this would be called the else block. And so one of these blocks will be executed because this expression will either be true or it'll be false. It can't be anything else. Okay, so over here is an example of what this looks like. And here, if the mouse is pressed, we're drawing circles. Otherwise, we're drawing rectangles. So let's go into processing and see what that looks like. So we type else, and then we have another open curly brace and a closed curly brace. And inside here, we're going to copy this code to save typing, but we're going to change it to be rect. So it'll draw a rectangle. So now if I run this, so now I see I'm not pressing the mouse button, so I'm drawing a rectangle. Now I press the mouse button, I'm dragging, I'm drawing circles, I let go of the mouse button, and now I'm drawing rectangles, okay? And so it's doing one thing or the other at all times. Okay. So you can actually do multiple different if statements in your code. So in this example, maybe we want to change the fill color depending on whether or not a key is pressed on the keyboard. Okay, so we can do something like that. So let's add this in. So if key pressed, and note that processing highlights key pressed and mouse X and mouse Y in pink because those are built-in variables. Then we can do fill and we'll do a greenish color like that. Else, if there isn't a key pressed, then we want to fill with a reddish color like this. Okay, and so now we have two different if statements sequentially. So the first thing we're going to do when we get into draw is set a color. The next thing we're going to do is decide on which shape. The color will be determined by whether a key is pressed on the keyboard. The shape will be determined by whether the mouse button is pressed. Okay, so there's no key pressed on the keyboard. Now I'm pressing a key. Now I've let go of the key. Now I'm pressing a key, right? But I'm not pressing the mouse down, so I'm still drawing rectangles. Now I'm pressing the mouse down, and drawing red circles, but I press a key down, now I'm drawing green circles, I let go of the key, I press a key, etc. Okay, so that's an example of sequentially using multiple different if statements. Now, we can also put multiple things inside a single if statement. So what if we want to control the color and the shape only using the mouse button? So an example would look like this. So we can do multiple things inside of the if block and inside of the else block. So inside this if block, we're setting the color to green and drawing circles. And that's if the mouse button is pressed. If the mouse button isn't pressed, then we're setting the color to red and drawing rectangles. So this will only draw green circles or red rectangles. So let's go and have a look at what that would look like. So now we put this is the green, so we put it in here, and this is the red, so we put it in here, and we get rid of this. So now we will only draw one or the other. So we're drawing red rectangles because the mouse button isn't pressed. Now the mouse button is pressed and we're drawing green circles. Now the mouse button isn't pressed, etc. Okay, so you can put many, many things inside of an if block or an else block. It doesn't have to be just one line of code. Okay, and so we will almost always use the curly braces. If you don't use the curly brace, only the very first line will be considered to be the thing done if this is true. And so as a habit, I think it's always a good idea to use the curly braces. Okay, also note the indentation. Everything in the if block here is indented, and everything in the else block is indented. And that makes it really easy to see those blocks separately. And makes your code much more readable. And as a hint, if you're coding and processing and things are just, the indentation is just a mess, processing will auto format your code for you if you press Command T on a Mac, or I think it's Control T on Windows. So for example, if I go back here and I for some reason had that like over there and that over here, and this was back here and it's just all of a mess, I can press Command T and processing will fix the indentation for me. So take advantage of this because it really makes things a lot easier. Okay, so you can also use your own Boolean variable. So here we have an example where we created a Boolean variable which is called draw circles. We set it to false, and now in this code, we say if draw circles, then we draw circles, and otherwise we draw a rectangle. So this is very, very similar to the code we just had. So let's go and make our code look like this. So Boolean draw circles equals false. And then instead of basing this on mouse pressed, we're gonna do draw circles. And this you may look at this and guess, well, wait a second. Because this is false, we're never gonna draw circles, we're always gonna draw rectangles. And if you guess that, then you're definitely following along well. So let's run this. And you'll see that it doesn't matter what we do here, we're only drawing rectangles. And that's because of the way the Boolean variable is set and we're never changing it. But we could change it, for example, in response to a mouse click. So void mouse clicked. And this is a built-in function in processing. And then we can set draw circles to be whatever draw circles wasn't. And the way that we do this is by using the exclamation mark, which is a not operator, and it sort of inverts whatever a Boolean is. So by saying draw circles equals not draw circles, if draw circles was true, this is going to set it to false. If draw circles was false, this is going to set it to true. So now let's try and run this. Okay. And so once I click the mouse button, now we changed. I click the mouse button again, we changed back, change. Click the mouse button again, and we change back. Okay, so that's an example of using your own variable, draw circles, in an if statement. Okay, so just note that the exclamation mark is a not operator that inverts a Boolean So if true becomes false and false becomes true. Okay. Last thing we want to talk about in this intro to if statements and Booleans is that blocks have scope. So just like functions have scope, anything inside of curly brackets is its own scope. And so this example shows really problematic coding that will generate an error. So we've got an if statement, we've got an expression, and inside this curly brace we say int gray value equals 64. And what this does is it creates a box in memory called gray value and puts 64 in it. But the minute we get down to this curly brace, that box in memory disappears. And then down here, we do the same thing, but we put 192 in it. And the minute we get down here, that box disappears. And then we get to this line down here and we try to set stroke to gray value. There is no gray value. Okay, so we've used gray value three times here, but we've actually got only two boxes in memory. The third one was never declared. This is going to cause an error. And it's because these things are only in scope inside of the curly braces in which they were declared. So to fix this, you would do something like this. At the top, you say int gray value. And then inside here, you set it. So you set it to this, else you set it to that. And then you can use it down here and it's still in scope. Okay. So that's it for the intro to if statements. So we've covered if and if else, and the basic idea of Boolean variables, which can only be true or false. Thanks for watching.